Hello everyone and welcome to Machine Minutes with GROB. Spindle maintenance is crucial to maximize your machine's uptime, which keeps your spindle running at its full potential. Today we are going to show you how to replace the spindle clamping set on your GROB machine. If the spindle clamping set is malfunctioning or has an excessive amount of damage, then it must be replaced. To start the replacement procedure, be sure the spindle is in the unclamped position by pressing the spindle clamp and unclamp button on the HMI. Insert the proper sized Allen socket into the center of the spindle and a wrench on the spindle nose. Turn the Allen socket counterclockwise and hold the wrench stationary. Loosen but do not remove the black hot clamp spindle nose. Now clamp the spindle using the spindle clamp unclamp button on the HMI. Then remove the hot clamp nose from the spindle by turning it counterclockwise by hand. Remove the fingers by pushing down and then pulling out. Be ready to catch the fingers as they are under spring tension. You want to avoid them falling into the conveyor. Once all seven fingers are removed, use a pair of needle nose pliers to pull out the spring-loaded bushing. Use a pick set to remove the O-ring from the drawbar. Now let's look at what comes in the spindle clamp set replacement kit.
You can see the kit contains a pack of grease, new hot clamp nose, spring-loaded bushing, a set of fingers, and three O-rings.
Be sure to only use the black O-ring during the assembly of the clamping set.
To start the reassembly phase, first insert the new O-ring over the drawbar threads and place it into the groove.
You will notice that the O-ring fits loosely when placed into the groove. It's designed to fit this way. Next, lightly grease the seven keys of the spring-loaded bushing. Then slide the spring-loaded bushing over the drawbar with the keys facing towards you until it bottoms out inside the spindle. Now, lightly grease the contact points on the fingers. Align the slot on the finger with the key found on the spring-loaded bushing in the 6 o'clock position. Place two more fingers on opposite sides of the first finger placed inside the spindle. These three fingers should be laying loosely side by side without tension. Do not force them in. Using a long T-handle Allen wrench, compress the keys of the spring-loaded bushing by pressing inward on one of the keys while putting pressure on the fingers by hand. All three fingers should be stiff. For the remaining four fingers, simply press them in until you hear a slight click as they slide into place. Once all seven fingers are properly seated, they should all have tension and form a circle. Next, grease the contact points on the hot clamp nose. Also, grease the inside with lithium grease to ease over the O-ring while threading in the component. Insert the hot clamp nose and then start to thread it into place. You should tighten it by hand until it is approximately flush with the spindle face. If you feel tension while tightening, remove the OT clamp nose and reapply grease. You don't want to tear the O-ring. Once the OT clamp nose is in position, unclamp the spindle. Torque the OT clamp nose by inserting the proper size Allen socket into the center of the spindle and a wrench on the nose itself. Once the spindle nose is properly torqued, cycle the clamping set two or three times by pressing the spindle clamp unclamp button. Now the spindle needs to be in the unclamped position so we can check the clamping set dimension. To do this, you will need a depth gauge. Be sure the depth gauge you are using is zeroed before measuring. Measure the distance between the flat faces on the nose and the rest pads on the spindle face. Repeat this measurement 180 degrees from the first measurement and take the average. Consult your documentation to verify the depth measurement of your specific spindle type. If the measurement does not match the specification, the spindle nose will need adjusted. To do this, unclamp the spindle. Then loosen the OT clamp nose as we did before and adjust accordingly by turning the nose in or out. Torque the clamping set again by inserting the proper sized Allen wrench into the center of the spindle and a wrench on the spindle nose. Cycle the clamping set two to three times by pressing the spindle clamp unclamp button on the HMI. With the spindle in the unclamped position, measure the clamping set dimension again. Repeat this process until the dimension is within tolerance of the specified spindle. Be sure to check the clamping set dimension again after 500 cycles. Join us in our next video to learn more about your GROB Machining Center. Until then, stay productive, keep cutting, and we'll catch you next time.